Our goblet squat is a strength exercise for the legs. It is called a goblet squat because you are holding that weight in that front position, kind of like you would hold a goblet or a big cup. You can do this with one dumbbell, just like I was showing you, or you can always, to add or change weight, you can grab two dumbbells, holding it in that same position. That goblet position is one that is going to work not only those legs, but it's also going to work a little bit of your posture as well. Keeping that weight right here without pulling you over is going to work the low back as well as the upper back, those postural muscles back there throughout that movement. Set up for this, normal squat position, feet about hip distance apart, toes just slightly pointed out. You're always going to be changing that foot position based on individual differences. Based on how those hip sockets are positioned on you, you may feel a little more comfortable with a little wider stance. You may feel a little comfortable with a little more inward stance. Play around with it. Find one that allows you to keep that good form and allows you to get as much range of motion as possible. And then you're going to kind of want to stick to that one. Main thing is when you're changing your foot positioning, you want to make sure those knees are fairly well tracking over the toes. We're not collapsing inward like this, and we're not pushing outward too much on those knees. We kind of want to stay right over those feet throughout that movement. So, common mistakes made on this one. Most common mistake is not keeping your posture and allowing that weight to pull that upper body over. So if you have that weight and you get in your position first, and you come down and you find that it's kind of rocking you over like this, it's going to put a lot more strain on the low back. You might not have the strength in those postural muscles yet to keep that good position. So drop down in weight or go to body weight. Make sure that you can go through that movement by pushing those hips back, keeping that nice straight back, and not hinging on over and putting all that pressure on that low back before you start to progress in weight. That's the first main mistake. Second main mistake on this one, not bending the legs very much and instead getting all that bending coming from the hips, kind of like we would do on a deadlift. So coming down like this and kind of hinging on over and coming back up. Notice my legs are not bending very much. This kind of goes hand in hand with that first exercise. If I don't bend my legs very much, but I'm still trying to get that movement, I'm going to fall forward and I'm going to put that pressure on that low back. So make sure you push those hips back. Sit down into that squat like you're coming down onto a low stool. The other main mistake I see made in this one is not keeping those feet flat on the floor, and instead when we're coming down, we kind of rock forward onto those toes and then rock back. That's going to transfer more pressure onto the knees. We want to make sure we're keeping those feet flat on the floor so we can engage our glutes and hamstrings and keep that good position, transfer all of that pressure throughout the legs for that entire movement. Get down nice and low. Everybody's going to be a little different with how far down you can get. If you can, get all the way down, touch those knees to those elbows. Otherwise, just get as much range of motion as you can while keeping a nice straight back and good form on this exercise.